needed. Stand up one more time, and let's sing one more chorus this morning.
Oh, soon and very soon, we are gone to see the King. Oh, soon and very soon, we are gone to see the King. Soon and very soon, we are gone to see the King. Hallelujah, hallelujah, we're gone to see the King. We'll see King Jesus there. We are going to see the King. We'll see King Jesus there. We are going to see the King. We'll see King Jesus there. We are going to see the King. Hallelujah, hallelujah, we're going to see the King. Oh, soon and very soon, we are going to see the King. Soon and very soon, we are going to see the King. Oh, soon and very soon, we are going to see the King. Hallelujah, hallelujah, we're going to see the King. We'll see King Jesus there. We are going to see the King. We'll see King Jesus there. We are going to see the King. We'll see King Jesus there. We are going to see the King. Hallelujah, hallelujah, we're going to see the King.
Raise your hands and praise God. Heavenly Father, walk these aisles where that seamless robe anointed with power but come to be that lame leg healer, that blind eye opener, leper cleanser, dead man raiser in this service today. In Jesus' name. Turn around, shake hands with about a half a dozen. Tell them you're glad they're with us. Shake their hands and tell them you're glad that they're with us. Make them welcome in the service. Amen. Appreciate it. Now, you that have your Bibles, open them to the last book of the Bible, the book of Revelations. Turn with me to the first chapter and the 18th verse. And I am he that liveth and was dead, and behold, I am alive forevermore. Amen. And have the keys of hell and death. I'm he that liveth and was dead, and behold, I'm alive forevermore. Amen. And have the keys of hell and death. Isn't that wonderful? Come from the lips of our Savior Jesus of Nazareth. Now, that was a great saying to you that's here with us this morning. Let's reach back and let's look on where we come from and where we're going and how we got here and how we're going to get out. But Paul said in the 15th chapter of 1 Corinthians, but thanks be unto God, which give us the victory through Jesus Christ our Lord. He said, be ye steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, for as much as we know that our labor in the Lord is not in vain. Thanks be unto God, which give us the victory through Jesus Christ our Lord. That's the victory. He's speaking of victory. Jesus paid the price that we could have the victory. Victory over what? Victory over hell and victory over death. The Bible said in 6:23, Romans, the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. So there's a way out. There's a way in. There's a way out. And we must go out. Jesus paid the price. 1900 and some few years ago, we can see the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. We can see how that this thing got started. I can look back at Moses. I can find Moses leading the Israelites out of Egyptian bondage. I can see Moses headed there, and I can see him on the Mount Sinai when God gave out the commandments, and how that God gave the laws. You know, God's got laws. And we're not under law, we're under grace. May I say, we're not under the law, we're under grace. Thank God for the grace of God that bringeth salvation. Titus 2:11 have appeared unto all of us, teaching us to deny all ungodly and live righteously and soberly and godly in this present world. Thank God for the victory. All right, I see him, Jesus, having to go after the victory. I see Moses giving the law upon Mount Sinai. I can see how the ark of the covenant was there, and I can see how then God told him how to build the ark, how to prepare the ark of the covenant. I can see the mercy seat upon top of the ark made of pure gold. I can see the cherubims. One, there was two cherubims, one upon one side and one upon the other, and them facing one another. And I can see how they were made of pure gold, hooked to the mercy seat, no way to take them off. Them two cherubim, them two angels. I can see Michael. I can see Gabriel. I can see them facing one another on top of the mercy seat. I can see them two cherubims there. I can see the Ark of the Covenant. I can see the law down into the old ark. I can see it there, but I can see the mercy seat that had the ark covered. I can see how that God told Moses ever so often, says, you take the blood of bulls and the blood of pigeons and the blood of an animal, and you use them animals for sacrifices, and you take that blood in a basin, and you take your finger seven times and dip that blood upon the mercy seat. And I can see Moses as all the commandments was kept in, and I can see how that the mercy seat was 2.5 cubits long and 1.5 cubits wide, 27 inches wide, 47 inches long, how that it fit in the ark and sat on top. And I can see the blood that was on top of there from the animals and the bulls and the goats. I can see that. I can see the place that only once a year that the priest could go back into the holies of holies, and he could go there for the saints of God, and the priest had to go back there, and I can see him go behind the veil and plead the cause of the people. I can see them coming to the priest. I can see the priest going back into the holies of holies and pleading for the people. But thank God, Jesus said, I'm not pleased with that. I'm not pleased with that. He said, the blood of the bulls, the blood of the goats, the blood of the pigeons. He said, it was only temporarily. But said, I'll go that my blood can be shed for eternal. Clap your hands. I feel the victory. I can look at Jesus, God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Ghost. They can say that something, war, has got started in camp. I can see how that Lucifer was once an archangel. Lucifer was in heaven. Lucifer started war, false accusation. Again, the brethren started war in heaven. I can see God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost holding conference and say, what are we going to do with Lucifer? I can see him say, we'll cast him out, and we'll cast him down to the earth. We'll get him out of heaven, because he has started war in heaven. Honey, there'll be no sin in heaven. Whether you make it or I make it or who makes it, there'll be no sin in heaven. Jesus, the Father, the Son, the Holy Ghost, they come together and said, Lucifer has got to be cast out of heaven. They cast him out. Down to the earth he came. And when he come down here, he said, I'll set up my kingdom on this earth. This will be my, honey, this world is not my home. It's just a dressing room. I'm passing through. I'm here today and gone tomorrow. But thanks be unto God, which give me the victory through Jesus Christ our Lord. Clap your hands. I feel the victory. When I seen him cast out, I see Gabriel was the archangel of the Father. I can see Michael, the archangel of the Holy Ghost. I can see Lucifer, the archangel of Jesus. I can see Jesus tell the Trinity, God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Said, how are we going to defeat Satan? He's cast out of heaven. He's gone down to the earth. Jesus said, I'll go down there. I'll defeat him. I'll be born of a virgin. Matthew 1:21 said, she shall bring forth a son. Thou shalt call his name Jesus, for he shall save his people from their sins. Not in their sins, but from their sins. I'm going down there. I'm going to defeat the devil on his own territory. I'm going to bring him out of there. Hallelujah. Jesus was born in Bethlehem, born in an ox stall, born of a virgin conceived of the Holy Ghost. Jesus left his riches. He become poor that we might become rich. He was wounded that we might be healed. He died that we might live. Thanks be unto God. Give him the clap offering. I feel the victory in this tabernacle. Brother, when he come down here, born in that ox stall, stepped on the scene of the age of 30. I can see Satan with all his demonic powers walking the face of this earth trying to conquer it. He's still loose today. I can look at John 10:10, said a thief cometh not but to steal and to kill and to destroy. Honey, the devil's not your friend. He's your enemy. He come to defy you. He come to destroy you. But Jesus Christ come that we'd have life and have it more abundant life. Thank God. He said, I'll leave the right hand of my Father, and I'll go down there and I'll preach the gospel. I'll be born of that virgin. I'll die on that cross, and I'll suffer for their sins, not my sins, Jesus said, but for their sins. Jesus knew no sin, neither was any guile found within his mouth. But he come down here. I can see him in the temple when the doctors and the lawyers come to question him. They were astonished when he was just a child at the age of 12, how that he knew all things. Honey, Jesus is the author. He's a finisher of my faith, who for the joy endured the cross and sit down at the right hand of the Father. I've come to preach. Honey, we've come to have church. And I see the resurrection. I see the burial. I see the crucifixion. But I see the Lamb of God. When John the Baptist saw him coming down the road, he said, behold, there cometh the Lamb of God to take away the sins of the world. He said, I must decrease, but he must increase. Honey, we go. John said, I'm headed for a falling, but he's headed for a rising. If I go down, he'll come up. Honey, Jesus come back to this world to save me and you and pay the sin penalty on the cross of Calvary. Not for his sins, but my sins and your sins. Give him a real good cup offering. I can see him step on in the ministry at the age of 30. Turn the water to wine. I can see the demons of hell screeching and screaming. I can see them following him every footstep of the way. Thank God. But I can see them as he went through this life. He preached for 3.5 years, performed 36 miracles in the New Testament, give 46 prophecies, and them 46 prophecies, 45 of them has already come to pass. There's only one of them that's not come to pass. And honey, stands to reason, if 45 of their prophecies has already come to pass, that 46th one is coming to pass. And that one is, if I go away, I will come again, and I'll receive you unto myself, that where I am, there you may be also. He's coming back. Praise God. I can see him walking, performing the miracles. I can see him around the pools of Bethesda. I can see him anointing the eyes of the lame, the halt, the withered. I can see the blind seeing. I can see the deaf hearing. I can see him turning the water to wine. Honey, I can see him perform them 36 miracles. And just before he got ready to go and he was getting ready for his preparation on Palm Sunday, he come riding that donkey into town. Honey, he come riding. He left there and come up to Jerusalem. Oh, glory, to be tried and put on the cross and die, that you and I might live and have life and have it more abundantly. If you're lost and you're without Jesus, don't forget God loved you so much he gave his only begotten son. Oh, that we'd have life and have it more abundantly. He died that we might live. He come down here and they crucified him, but he rose again. He walked out victoriously over death, grave, and the hell. He said, I got the keys to death and hell, and because I live, you live also, and the works I do, a greater works can you do. Thank God he went there. He paid the price. I can see the time closing out. I can see him riding it on Palm Sunday, come riding that donkey into town. I can see him laying their coats down the streets, their garments. I can see him laying the palm leaves and him coming by. I can see him riding that donkey into town. I can see him on Monday of that holy week. I can see him come out and look at a fig tree, and there was no figs upon the tree, and he cursed the fig tree because he give it plenty of time to put fruit upon the tree, and the fruit did not come on the tree. He walked over to the tree, and the tree had a lot of limbs upon it, expecting to receive some fruit, but there wasn't no fruit upon the tree, and he cursed the fig tree. Oh, I can see him on Tuesday, how he walked back by, and his disciples was astonished and amazed, and they looked at that fig tree and said, that's a peculiar thing, how we were here yesterday and that fig tree had big green leaves upon it, and today that big fig tree has withered away and died. I can see him cleansing the temple with a cat of nine tails. Honey, he went in the house of the Lord upon Tuesday and he cleansed the temple. He got the Pharisees straightened out. He let them know that he come into Jerusalem to be the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. He got the house of God in order. Honey, he's coming back again to get the house of God back in order. I can see churches all over the world, how they've left the gospel, how preachers are scared to preach the gospel. They've got padlocks upon their jaws. They've been to seminaries and cemeteries, and they're ever learning but never able to come to the knowledge of the truth, and they're not preaching the truth. Most of them is not preaching the truth. Honey, it's no more than a social gathering. But the time is coming when Jesus said, we'll worship God in the spirit and we'll worship God in the truth. I wasn't for the church and go there if the preacher wasn't preaching the truth and got in the Holy Ghost, casting out devils, healing the sick, cleansing the lepers, raising the dead, and preaching the gospel unto the poor, unto the lame a walking, and the dumb a talking, and blind eyes are being opened. Would you clap your hands? I feel like preaching. Hey, the Holy Ghost is moving in this place. Praise God. I can see him upon Wednesday as he kind of, the Bible goes silent, kind of silence on what he done upon Wednesday. Yes, sirree. There's not too much recorded that Jesus done on Wednesday of that holy week. But upon Thursday, I can see him coming into town making preparation for the trial. They were going to put him on trial. It should have been me on trial. It should have been you on trial. It should have been the world on trial. But they reached out and got a hold of the Lamb of God, the only one that was sinless, Thank God that left his riches in glory and become poor that we might become rich. He become wounded that we might be healed. He died that we might live. Honey, there's way. He said, I'm come after the keys. Honey, let me tell you something. There's not but one way for you to get in that door, and that's for Jesus Christ. Says, I'm the door, I'm the way, and I'm the life. There'll be no life. He said, if you eat my flesh, he said, except you eat my flesh and you drink my blood, there'll be no life within you. He that eateth my flesh and drinketh my blood has everlasting life, and I'll raise him up at the last day. What last day? Honey, the time's coming, and now is, that Gabriel is going to blow the trumpet and swear by him till the heavens be no more, and put one foot upon the sea and the other upon the land, and the dead in Christ are going to rise first, and we which are alive and we remain be changed in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, and caught up in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air, and so shall we ever be together with the Lord. Comfort one another with these words. What words? The words of Paul, the words of Jesus. Hallelujah. May I say this? Glory, glory, praise God. I can see Jesus preparing for Thursday night for the trial. I can see Pontius Pilate when he come, and they would not have nobody else. He tried to get Jesus out of it, but they said, crucify him, crucify him, crucify him. I see Pontius' wife, and she had a dream, and she sent word to Pontius Pilate, have nothing to do with this man. I've had a dream. That's a good man. Let him alone. And Pontius Pilate went back before the people and tried to plead Jesus' case. And they said, no, crucify him. Crucify him. That's what the world is doing this morning. They're crucifying him. They want away with him. Away with Jesus. Give me the world. Give me the world. You take Jesus and give me the world. That's what they're crying. But you know what I'm crying? Give me Jesus. And you take the world. You can have the whole world. But give me Jesus. How many feel it? You know why? Honey, he's going to be the winner. He's not the loser. I'm he that was dead. But behold, I'm alive forevermore. I got the keys to death and hell. And because I live, you live also. And the works I do, greater works can you do. Because I go back. Honey, I'm going to preach this thing. I feel the Holy Ghost now. And I feel the power of God moving. We've come after it. If you've got the victory, you've got the victory. But if you're not saved, you're lost. You're either going to heaven or you're going to hell. Jesus come and paid the price. Give him a real good cup offering. I can see Jesus that night across in the Brook of Kedron. I can see him go over there kneeling in the garden to pray. He says, can't somebody pray with me? Just 1 hour. And you can't find people nowadays that'll pray 1 hour. Hallelujah. Can't find somebody that'll pray with me 1 hour. And let me tell you something. Long come, then about 600 of those Roman soldiers led by Judas Iscariot. Hallelujah. One of his own 12 that had betrayed him and was selling him for 30 pieces of silver, $19.64 a piece for silver, $19.20. Judas Iscariot sold Jesus for. Some of you are selling out for less than that. Esau sold his birthright for a cold bowl of pottage, a cold bowl of beans. He got out, sold out, give out. Honey, some of you is getting out for less than that. But I see Judas, one of them that he loved, one of the 12 that had cast out devils, had washed feet and went with Jesus. I've seen him turn his back upon the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. He the more come out. You listen to this preacher, but thank God I'm not looking at Judas. I'm looking at that 11. I'm not looking at them that won't. I'm looking at them that will. I'm not looking at them that can't. I'm looking at them that can. Honey, we got the plan in our hand, and Jesus is going to walk with us. He said, I'll never leave you. I'll never forsake you, but I'll go with you to the end of the world. What more do we won't. We're winners. We're not losers. The Word of God's alive forevermore. It can't die. Jesus has got the victory, and give me the victory. He give you the victory, and we got to walk over the devil. If you don't walk over him, he'll walk over you. I feel the victory. You listen to me. Praise God. I can see Judas Iscariot come over with 600 soldiers and betrayed him with a kiss. Kissed him on his cheek and betrayed him and sold him for 30 pieces of silver. I can see them soldiers reach out and grab my King of Kings and my Lord of Lords down kneeling and praying in the garden. And he prayed like this: Father, not my will, but thine be done. Oh, Father, let this cup pass from me, but nevertheless, if not my will, but thine be done. And if you can keep on praying until you get that kind of victory, Father, not my will, but thine be done. Honey, God's going to move in your life. He's going to use you. You got to forget yourself. You're not the one that died. You're not the one that was crucified. But he was the one that went to a cruel cross, shed his blood upon that cross. He died that we live. He went down that we come up. He was wounded that we might be healed. Thank God, and by his stripes, I am healed. We were healed. We are healed. Clap your hands for the real Holy Ghost victory. You know, some of us down Brother Peter for his slip he made when Jesus, Peter said, if that be you, Jesus, bid me to come to you. And he said, come. Come on. Oh, Peter got out the boat. And when he did, he started walking the water. Isn't that wonderful? Walking the white caps of Galilee and walking the water toward Jesus. Yes, sirree. He walked the water. And because his buddies back in the boat began saying, you better stay away from that old church. That may not be the right spirit. That may be the wrong spirit. Oh, you better get out of there. The devil don't want you to go where the Holy Ghost is moving. He don't want you to go where you can get healed. He don't want you to go where you can get something from God. He wants you to sit around an old dead head church. Lord, lay me down to sleep. I pray my soul to keep. Honey, it's going to keep all right. It's going to keep in the wrong place. You better get out of there and get in summers. It's on fire for God. And not lukewarm, but shouting and praising the Lamb of God. Honey, I'm going to preach this thing. He's alive. He's not dead. He's alive. He's walking the aisles wearing that seamless robe. It's anointed with power. Did you know he's alive this morning? He's not there. When he did, 600 soldiers come up. But one of them, by the name of Malchus, reached out to get a hold of Jesus and grabbed him. And the Apostle Peter showed his love for Jesus and pulled out that sword and cut his ear off. Next to the last miracle performed in the Bible, the 35th miracle that Jesus performed was when he put that man's ear back on his head that had fell off. He cut his ear off. You know what somebody said the other day? Did you know he cut a man's ear off? I said, it's a wonder to me he didn't cut his head off. I believe he meant to cut his head off. Honey, he cursed, he swore, he done everything in the book. He cut the man's ear off. He'd fight you on a short notice because he was a fisherman. But let me tell you something. He went to the upper room, the supper room, and Peter got the baptism of the Holy Ghost and the initial evidence of speaking with other tongues and come out of the upper room on fire for God. You can't deny this. You can't defy this. I'm preaching you the truth. That old weak Peter, you called him, will come out of there alive. He come out of there on fire. He come out of there preaching. He come out of there a new Peter. You'll never find nothing else wrong in Peter's life. But he cut his ear off. Yes, sirree. And Jesus reached down, picked it up, and put it back on the 35th miracle of the Bible. Only 36 performed. Now you listen to me. They took a hold of him. They took him to Pontius Pilate's hall. I was there a few months ago, and I looked it all over. And I looked inside where they put Jesus on trial. I looked Pontius Pilate's hall over, how that they all denied him, and they forsook him, and Peter denied him, and others denied him. They defied, and they left him without. They run, they left him. But Jesus faced that awful scourging and that awful trial, that unfair trial. They plucked his beard. They spit in his face. They cursed him. They blasphemed him. They say, you say you're the King of Kings. And if you're the King of Kings, why don't you do something about it? My God, hallelujah. He said, no man takes my life. I give my life. Hallelujah. He come to Jerusalem to give his life. He come to lay down his life. But he was going to pick it up again. Honey, that goes down, it'll come up. Jesus said, if you tear down this temple, it took years, 40 years to build it. But if you tear it down, I'll build it again in 3 days. Let me finish it, saints. Come on. He's building a temple. He's building a tabernacle. This corruptible must put on incorruption. And this mortal must put on immortality and be brought to pass in that saying that death is swallowed up in victory. Oh, death, where is thy sting? Now, grave, where is thy victory? But thanks be unto God, which give me the victory through Jesus Christ, my Lord. Clap your hands. I've never felt like preaching anymore in my life. Brother, they took him Thursday night, tried him all night long. Pontius Pilate's wife tried to help get him out of it. No way. They said, crucify him. The next morning, being Friday morning, they took him up and placed that big Roman, average weight of a Roman cross, 390 pounds, upon the shoulders of Jesus of Nazareth. Took him down that cobble street, headed towards Golgotha, the place they call Skull. I looked at it, and I looked it over, how he went up that place. Who for? It wasn't for him. Nothing he'd done. It was all for me and for you. It was for the alcoholics. It was for the dope addicts, the dope pushers. It was for the prostitutes, the harlots. It was for the unsaved, the lost. It was for the one that's on his road to hell. Oh, Jesus loves you. He loves you. Sinner, if you're listening to me, I want to throw you the lifeline and you listen to me. God so loved you that he gave his only son, hallelujah, that you'd live and not die. Oh, come out of there. You're going to face death. Hebrews 9:27 said it's appointed unto a man once to die and then the judgment. Verse 28, for Christ was once offered to bear the sins of many. Unto all them that look for him shall he appear the second time without sin unto salvation. He took his disciples on the top of the Mount of Olives after the resurrection and led them out there. And honey, while he was disciple was looking at him, a cloud came down and received him up out of their sight. As them, his disciples were standing there, two men dressed in white apparel said, why gaze ye up into heaven? That same Jesus that just left shall return in like manner. In 14:1 he said, let not, St. John, your hearts be troubled. If you believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I'd have told you so. But if I go away, I will come again, and I'll receive you unto myself, that where I am, there you may be also. Give him another good clap offering. Brother, as he took that cross and carried it most of the way, it was a centurion that come and got up under the load of the cross with him. When they took those 3 spikes and nailed him to the cross, one in each hand, through each hand. I mean, you could hear it, the bones cracking when they had him down, holding him and putting his hand to that cruel Roman cross. As they beat him and they'd whipped him and plucked out his beard and spit in his face and blasphemed him, and the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords had to suffer this for me and for you. I want to emphasize it. It wasn't for himself. It was for me and it was for you. Not his sins. He knew no sin. He was born of a virgin, conceived received of the Holy Ghost, but he done it for me. He so loved me, he laid down on that cross, and they took those spikes and drove one in his right hand and the other one in his left hand, and took his feet and crossed his feet and put another spike into his feet, and took that big Roman cross and took it on top of the place called Skull, and dug the hole and dropped it down in there. And I can hear it slosh, I can hear the juggle, I can hear the beat, I can hear the groan, I can hear the cry. The same man that come to Jacob's well, they called Sychar, and met a little woman there, hallelujah, and him being weary and tired, how much more human could Jesus have been? A lot of people come to me and say, oh, I know that was God's son. God moved all pain from him. God didn't move nothing away from him. God turned his head. God turned his head. And honey, he could have called for more than 12 legions of angels that got him from the cross, but he didn't do it. He went ahead with it. He suffered. He suffered. He died on that cruel cross. Oh yeah, would you let me preach? He cried from the cross and said, Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani, my God, why has my Father forsaken me? My God, why has thou forsaken me? And God turned his back long enough to let Jesus give up the ghost. He said, it's finished. It's finished. Honey, let me tell you something. When it was finished for me. It was finished for you. My sins and your sins and all my healings and my wounds, he put them under the blood. Would you clap your hands? I feel the victory. Glory. Glory. Give up the ghost. Give up the ghost. Nicodemus, come to Jesus by night in the third chapter of St. John. Come with Joseph of Arimathea and help beg the body of Jesus. Joseph was a rich man. He come help beg the body of Jesus. Nicodemus come along with him. Somebody said didn't know where Nicodemus got saved or not. Let me give you this. That morning when we get in that city, I expect to find Brother Nicodemus with Jesus. You know why? He come with Joseph to help beg the body of Jesus. I won't help beg the body for no man that I don't believe in. If I don't believe in him, I won't go there. Now, Nicodemus come there to help beg the body, help bury him and put him away. Oh, hallelujah. He laid down his life. He said, but if I lay it down, I'll pick it up again. I'll pick it up again. You can't crucify me. You can crucify me. You can't kill me. You can put me to death, but I'll live forever. I'm coming out of there. I'll rise again. Honey, let me tell you something. The Son of God is a King of Kings. He's a Lord of Lords. They can't destroy him. They tried it. Now I've got you where you want me. Give me just a few more minutes. I feel the anointing here. I feel the fire in the tabernacle. I feel the pillar of cloud over this place. I feel a pillar of fire coming down in here in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. When he gave up the cross, he gave up the ghost, and they took him down and laid him in a borrowed tomb. Hallelujah. I went there. I looked it over. But while his body was there, while his body was in that tomb, that inward man, Jesus, come out of the outward man. You listen to me. Hallelujah. I believe it's 1 Corinthians 15, chapter in the 15th verse. Flesh and blood cannot inherit the kingdom of God. Neither does corruption inherit corruption. The 51st verse of 1 Corinthians, the 15th chapter. Behold, I'll show you a mystery. A mystery is something we don't understand. We shall not all sleep, but we shall all be changed in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye. Honey, we won't all be asleep. Nowhere's in the Testament does a man die. He starts living. In the Old Testament, Abraham lived to be so old. Sarah, 127 years. Noah, 950. Methuselah, 969. But they all died. They all died. Jesus said, he that believeth upon me, though, and in St. John 5:28, behold, the hour's coming, and now is, for them that's in the graves shall hear the voice of the Son of Man and come forth into everlasting life. And Daniel 12:2, many of them which sleep in the dust of the earth shall shall awake into everlasting life and some everlasting contempt. I see in the book of 20th chapter of Revelations, the Bible said in the 20th chapter in the 6th verse, blessed and holy he that have part in the first resurrection, for the second death have no power, but we'll be priests of God and of Christ, and we'll reign with him 1,000 years. Revelation chapter 20 and verse 12, I saw the dead, small and great, stand before God, and the books was open, and another book was open, which was the book of life, and every man was judged out of the things which was written in the book. Honey, there's a book. The Bible said in St. John 5:39, search the scriptures, for in them you think you have eternal life. It's those that testify of me. Honey, I feel the fireball of the preacher of the anointing of camp meeting in the tabernacle, and I feel the glory of God. I feel Jesus walking the aisle with that seamless robe. It's anointed with power. He's a lame leg healer. He's a blind eye opener. He's a leper cleanser. He's a dead man raiser. He's a gospel preacher. He's a great I am. He's a bright morning star. He's a wonderful counselor. He's a prince of peace. He's the almighty. He's the everlasting father. He's the alpha. He's the omega. He's the beginning. He's the ending. He's the first. He's the last. He's the Christ. That man of Galilee. Would you clap your hands? I feel the victory. Closing on this. You know what? While his body was there, the inward Jesus come out and went down to hell. Went down to hell to preach to the spirits that was in Abraham's bosom. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The Bible said, upon this rock, 16th chapter of Matthew, I'll build my church, and the gates of hell. Now, hell has got gates. You put that down in your boot. Hell has got gates to keep them in there. There ain't no gates around heaven, because they're going to be opened, and we can go in day and night. Hallelujah. How many feel this? How many feel this? And brother, I see Jesus go down there and preach to the spirits that was in prison, that never had a chance to get out and come out. But I see Jesus going down to redeem them. I seen him going after them. I seen him come down there unto Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, and all the patriarchs of God. And when they were silenced, oh yeah, honey, there'll be silence in heaven for the space of a half an hour. But you listen to me. I can see Jesus come down to redeem all the patriarchs of God and round them up. Hallelujah. And when he got them all rounded up, he went down to hell to preach in hell to them that never had heard the gospel. He wanted to get the gospel to them. And from then on, would you listen to me? The Bible said when Jesus died and yielded up the ghost, he gave up the ghost, and he cried, Eli, Eli, my Sabachthani, my God, why hast thou forsaken me? The veil of the old temple was rent from the top to the bottom, not from the bottom to the top, because it come from the top to the bottom. You know why it come from the top to the bottom? If it would have come from the bottom to the top, they'd have said, man rent it. That veil was 30 feet wide and 60 feet tall, and nobody could go back in there but the priest once a year. Oh, hallelujah. But boy, when he cried, it's finished, and the veil of the temple was rent and twain from the top to the bottom. From the top to the bottom, God done it. It started at the top and went to the bottom. That proves to me. And he opened it up. It used to, the priest could only go in there, but now me and you can go into the holies of holies with our own prayers and our own petitions. Honey, the priest ain't got to go there for me. I ain't got to confess to the priest. I can tell my God my needs. I've not got to pray to Mary. I can pray to Jesus. He's the one died. He's the one that rose again. He's the one that walked out. He's the one come out victoriously. Would you clap your hands? I've never felt like preaching any more than my life. My God, it's finished. It's finished. I'm going in the holies of holies. I'm going where I ain't never been. Honey, we can go now and plead our own case. Clap your hands for the victory. Jesus, according to Matthew 27:52, when he was down there in loose things, out of the heart of the earth and come up. The Bible said many of them that slept arose and walked down the streets in Jerusalem. Jesus bailed them out. And when he was coming up, he brought them up with him. And Jesus told him, you stay here for a little bit. I got to go over to the garden. I got a little business to tend to over in the garden. Hallelujah. You people stay here, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, and all the patriarchs of God, and all of them that he brought out of hell and brought them up. And he walked down the streets, many slept, walked down the streets in Jerusalem. You stay here. I got to go over to the garden. And when he got over to the garden, he met Mary Magdalene over there. He met some of the others over in the garden. And Mary Magdalene said, I don't know where she's supposing him to be the gardener. You know, listen to me. Oh, my God. I've just got into the goodies of this. She got over and supposing him to be the gardener. Said, if you know where you bore him and where you've laid him, please tell me and I'll go get him. We thought he was going to be the king. And now he's gone and left us. Where did you lay him? But about that time, the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords looked over at Mary and called her name. She thought he was the gardener, supposing him to be the gardener. Oh, it was a little dusty. The sun was rising that morning. You listen to me. And he turned around and looked at her, and through them tears, she couldn't see him clearly. Thank God. And he said, Mary, Mary. It was like turning on God's recorders. Nobody could say Mary like Jesus could say it. Nobody can call your name like Jesus can call it. Whosoever calleth on the name of the Lord shall be saved. But when Jesus come walking the billow waves and speaks peace to your waters, and there's a great calm, and Jesus talks to the wind, and Jesus talks to the waters, and everything ceases, and all troubles is over, and all your trials is over. He's a King of Kings. He's a Lord of Lords. Honey, he's not dead. He's alive. I was in Jerusalem just a few months ago, and I took my handkerchief and I wiped it down in the bottom of the tomb, and I fanned and cleaned it, and he's not there. He's gone. He's gone. He's gone. Where did he go? He went back where he come from, back to the right hand of the Father. How many feel it? But when he said Mary, Mary, he turned her on. Nothing could have been said no greater than Jesus to call Mary's name. When Jesus calls my name, Jimmy Dobbs, honey, I jump up and I say, yes, sir. What you want, Jesus? What do you want me to do, Lord? What you fixing to tell me, Jesus? Hallelujah. You know what? Hallelujah. What she said? He said, Mary. You know what she said? Rabboni. 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 You run that up and look up the interpretation of it. And she said, that is my master. My master. He said, Mary. He called her by her first name. And she called him who he was. My master. Honey, David said, he's my shepherd. He's my shepherd. Mary said, he's my master. Honey, if he's your master, he's your King of Kings. He's your Lord of Lords. If I've ever preached in a place, I'm preaching in this place this morning. And the glory of God is all over this tabernacle. There's fire. He's walking the aisle. He's not dead. He's alive. He's got the keys to death and hell. Let me close. Let me close. 3 days and nights he was gone. He went down to hell. I can see all the imps of hell after he died and gave up the ghost. They pulled freight and went back home, back down to hell to have a party. They said, well, he was an imposter. They wasn't nothing to him. And I knew they wasn't, because we've killed him. He said he'd rise again, but he gave up the ghost and he's dead. Now we'll let Nicodemus and Joseph of Arimathea take his body and lay it in a barred tomb. Let's go back down to hell and have a party. Let's go back down there. They got back down there pouring their champagne and holding their bottles and popping their glasses together. But about that time, somebody rung the doorbell to the gates of hell. and somebody, one of his imps, his demons, went to the gate and looked outside and come back screaming, said, "Jesus of Nazareth is at the gate." They said, "Oh, go on. You've had too much to drink. You've been partying too much." He said, another one of his imps, "You go and you look it over." And he went and looked. And when he got to the gate and peeped through the bars, he screamed, "Jesus of Nazareth, whom they crucified, has rose and come out of there." And went back to Pontius Pilate and all the kings around the table about half drunk and said, "That's him, King. That's Jesus of Nazareth. I know him. I fought him all the way up the hill. A skull. I know him. I was there when he healed the lame. I was there when he healed the withered. I went every mile of the way for 3 years and a half. I know him." He jumped up in a rampage and told his another one of his men, his imps, his demons, his devils, "You go to the gate. You know him. Go find out who it is." He went to the gates of hell. And when he got there and seen it was Jesus of Nazareth, he screamed, "That's Jesus at the gate," and run back and told him. And about that time, I can see Pontius Pilate and all the rest of them come there. I can see Herod and all the rest of them come to the gate. And they said, "What do you want?" He said, "I've come after the keys. I want the keys. What to? I want it to death and I want it to hell. I want to bail my people out. I've come to get them. I paid the price at Calvary. I brought them out of there. I've come to get them. I died that they might live. And I'm ringing the doorbells of hell that you get up and give me the keys." They said, "Get out of here." He said, "I'm not going to leave until you open them gates and give me my keys that I died for and they might live. I paid for it and I'm going to get my keys." Come on, saints. He's got the keys to death and hell. And because he lives, we live also. Listen, oh, have a hallelujah. Go ahead. Shout to victory. Shout to victory. He said, "Come on. Give me the keys." I can see the demons of hell come around and come over and pick up. Remind me of these big old keys that unlocks the jails. Used to put them in the door, click, click, clock, clock, click, way down there. But they come handing him the keys through the bars. He come to get them. He come after them. Said, "Give them here." And the demons of hell, screeching and screaming, handed him the keys and handed him through the bars. And Jesus of Nazareth unlocked the door and led Abraham, Isaac, and all the patriarchs of God that was bound up until he went down and bailed them out. He brought them out and brought them up and went back down the streets in Jerusalem. And oh, glory to God. Let me preach it. Honey, he's alive. He can't die. He said, "I'm alive forevermore. I got the keys to hell and to death." Hallelujah. How many feel it this morning? If I've ever preached, I preached to you this morning. Hallelujah. You listen to this preacher that's preaching to you. He can't lock me up because I've got one of the keys. Not this key, but I've got a key in my heart that he give me. And because I believe in him, whosoever believeth in the name of the Lord shall be saved. And when my singers come and my organ player comes up, all I got to do is believe. And when the devil knocks on my door, I get up and get my Holy Ghost key and I look through the door. I say, "What do you want?" They say, "We've come to deliver sickness to your house." I said, "Somebody else may have it down the street. I'm not going to have it. Get out of here. Get going. I bind you. The name of Jesus. I bind every demon, a screeching and a screaming and a hollering." But honey, did you know we got power over death, grave, and hell? Did you know he said, Jesus said in the 28th chapter of Matthew, about the 19th verse, he said, "All power is given to me in heaven and in earth. And because I live, you live also." He give us the same power. We got power if we'll use it. Don't sit there and not use it. He's alive. We got the keys to death and hell. when I get somewhere, hallelujah, like I was the other night, and I don't have no way in there. I know somebody that knows somebody on the inside, and they'll open the door for me. I've been to intensive cares where the doctor says, you can go in and pray if you want to, but it don't make no difference. They're going to die anyhow. I've had doctors to tell me this. I said, okay, I've got the keys to death and life and to hell. I'm going in there and I'm going to bail them out. I'm going to pray the prayer of faith that shall save the sick, and the Lord shall raise them up. And about that time, the third person in the Godhead will come walking through those closed doors and unlock the doors and put life where there's no life. He's alive. Jesus is alive. He's away. When he wake up, he's not dead. He's alive. We got the keys. Let's use them. Let's use them. Glory. Glory. He'll unlock my doors and unlock your doors. I'll admit there's doors that I can't open. But I know a man that's got the key to that door. And all things are possible to him that believeth. Don't you turn me off. And these signs shall follow them that believe. In my name, whose name? Jesus' name, will cast out devils, heal the sick, and cleanse the lepers, and raise the dead, and preach the gospel to the poor, and speak with new tongues as of fire. Honey, there's fire all over this tabernacle. There's a pillar of cloud by day and a pillar of fire by night. We arise when Gabriel blows a trumpet. The dead in Christ are going to rise, and we which are alive will be changed and caught up together in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. So shall we ever be together with the Lord. Let me leave you on this thought. 66th chapter of Isaiah said, we're looking for a new heaven and a new earth. He said, which is not made. It wasn't made. 2 Peter, the 3rd chapter, said, we nevertheless, according to his promise, are looking for a new heaven and a new earth. Still looking. Wherein dwelleth righteousness. Man, I feel it. 21st chapter of Revelation, John said, I saw a holy city, New Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride, adorned for the husband. With that garment, sweeping both sides of the aisles. Oh yeah, she's coming in. It ain't long, it's all over, but they're shouting. He's coming back for the church. Are you ready? We're going home. Stand with me. Sing. 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 Wave your hands and tell him you love him. You're headed for something. Wave your hands this morning. There's something here. There's something. If you believe in that, wave your hands. Wave your hands, saints, wave your hands. He could alone loose you from the cross. Come on, saints, raise your hands. He could have loosed you from the cross.
He could have come.
Leave your seats and come to the front of the church.
10,000 angels, but he died alone for you and me. He could have gone 10,000.
You better take time to pray. You better take time to pray. I've never felt the glory of God over a place like I feel it over here now. He's come to set you free.
He could have gone 10,000 angels.
Shout out of it.
But shout out of it. Alone.
Slip your hands up.
For you.
Slip your hands up.
Me.
Come on, slip your hands real high. Slip your hands up. Sing it, Kenny. One more verse.
In the garden where he prayed.
I may never preach the gospel
they
to you,
led him,
but I preach it this morning.
Through the street.
Thanks for watching this awesome video clip. If this sermon has been a blessing to you, help us out as we put more of these videos online. It takes thousands of dollars to put these videos online. Please go to PaxsonRevivalCenter.com and donate to help us spread the gospel to everyone in the world. Go to PaxsonRevivalCenter.com and click on the donate button. God will bless you.